Many hobbyist CNC machines don't have the automatic tool change. In addition, the bits used by these machines have different lengths. As a consequence, the tool change tends to be an annoying operation since it also implies a manual correction of the tool length offset. If we add to this that all the movements may be made by the user manually, the entire operation results even longer. In this video, you may see how we try to simplify this procedure with the ant farm. But first, let's say thanks to our kind sponsor, PCBWay, the high-quality PCB prototype service. Which characteristic shall a semi-automatic tool change have? What do we need? Firstly, we need a procedure that can be embedded in the workflow without modifying it. The user G code should not be altered. Moreover, we need to be able to manually remove the bit and replace it with a new one. But above all, the tool change procedure should compensate for the tool length difference automatically. For the first point, we didn't want to change the G-code file with any special command, so we decided to create a macro that translates the standard tool change command M6. To do this, we developed a draft macro parser that allows us to use the real-time information of the CNC machine. Thanks to this algorithm, we have the possibility to perfect the tool change strategy. To facilitate the manual tool change, we chose to place the head in a working position that makes it easy to remove the current tool bit and replace it with a new one. Then, the macro will have a sequence of commands that will apply a compensation for the tool change difference. To achieve this, we chose to use a prop command for the current and the new bit. Before removing the current bit, an automatic prop is executed to store the current tool length. The prop is done in a well-known user-defined point in the working area. When the new tool bit is inserted in the machine head, the ladder is placed in the same user-defined point, and a new automatic prop is done. With the old and new prop values, there is all needed information to compute the tool length offset. At this point, we were considering different ways to compensate for the offset. The G-code standard provides a variable suited for this goal, the tool length offset, TLO. Setting this variable to the difference of length of the tools that we acquired through the probes should be enough. Unfortunately, this system has a drawback. In GRVL, after a soft reset or an unlock, this variable is reset to zero. The consequences for this behavior could be dire. The machining bit could be broken by an unwanted collision. Luckily, there is another way. We could change the Z value of the working coordinate system in use to compensate for the different tool bit length. This is the strategy that we are using at the moment, and up to now, we didn't find any drawbacks. We think this solution is valid also for other types of machining, not just to mill PCBs. Thanks to the settings we are providing, it should be possible to use other probing mechanisms different from the one used by the ant. We want the ant farm to be a valid solution for different CNC machines, also if we develop and test it mostly using the ant. Before the execution of the tool change, some settings should be set according to the CNC machine used. The first parameter is the tool probe position. That is the position in which the machine performs the probes needed to compensate for the tool length offset. There are two ways to choose this probing point. An absolute machine's position could be used, and this is useful in case there is a touching tool in a fixed position in the working plane. Secondly, a position relative to the working zero could be used. Usually it is a clean and safe area for the proof. This is the solution that we use with the ant that has an integrated proving system. The easiest way to set this parameter is to use the machine connected with the ant farm. Place the head in the desired probing point, choose if you want an absolute or relative position, and then hit the Get Tool Proof Position push button. In a similar way, hitting the Get Tool Change Position push button, we could set a tool change place. That is the point where the machine heads shall go to easily change the tool. This set of coordinates is absolute, not related to the working zero. A good value to set the prof limit parameter is the maximum tool length difference of the tool bits you use. If you also set the feed rates according to your machine capabilities, you have set everything you need to perform the semi-automatic tool change. To verify that the tool change works properly, you may run a tool change directly from the user interface. This is what should happen. If any kind of disaster happens during these procedures, there could be some setting that should be slightly modified. If the tool change works properly, you may be quite confident that every time an exit command in your G-code is elaborated, the ant farm will run the tool change macro. In addition, in the last version of the ant farm, you can find a lot of small improvements. Download it, try it, and let us know what you think about it. We are working on completing the first two tabs. That should be enough to easily make one side PCBs. Then, we will dedicate our work to the alignment tab. That is the most difficult, but is the one that will allow you to create double-sided PCBs with ease. That's all, folks. Enjoy and see you in the next video. And subscribe!